Hi there. In this video, we are going to see an amazing feature provided to us by Postman, and that is called as Collection Runner. To understand that, if you might have worked into Selenium, right? So you use testng, you use testng.xml, right, to organize all your test class file so that you can execute them in a specific order. Okay, so with the help of Collection Runner, we are going to do something similar here. Right, so what is a collection? We've already seen that in the previous video, it's a set of requests, right? And the next agenda item for this video is the UI. We're going to explore the UI, then we are going to run a collection, and while running the collection, we are going to select the environment against which our request will be run. We'll set the number of iterations we want to run the collection. We'll introduce delay between the request within that collection, and we'll read data from the external JSON file. So I'll be covering this read data from external JSON file and supply those to your request in detail in upcoming video, but it's going to be a quick glance in this video. So next one would be your result and export result. So we'll see that in action. So this is going to be a UI. Let's spend like 30 seconds on this, and then we'll move on to the Postman application. So on the left hand side, you will see the collection that you are going to run and what all folders are there within that collection and the request at the root level of the collection, right? Inside these folders, you will have further requests, right? And you could see all of that in here. So this is, if you could see that, just to understand that this is a first copy, right? This is a second copy. So five requests into first copy, five requests into second copy, and these are the requests at the root of collection. Okay, so you can set the environment. So if your requests are dependent on any environment, then you have to provide the environment from this drop down. How many times you want to run your collection, so you can set the iteration from here. Again, the delay we already talked about, so an interval delay between each request within that collection, and the data that you want to pass. So for that, you have to select file. All right, so what is the run order, right? So as you could see that by default, your request will run in the sequence they are listed in the collection. However, we can change that by using this particular three line icon. You can drag it, and that will change the order of that, you know, drag up and down, and that will change the order of the execution. So when we start a collection, all requests are run in the order we will see them in the Postman. So all requests are executed first by order of the folder, and then any request in the root of the collection. Okay, let's see that. And yeah, so if you look at this diagram, so we can do manual API testing, we can write scripts, right? We can do documentation, collaboration team, talked about that in the first video of this series. Now what we are doing is, with the help of collection runner, we are executing the whole collection. So we are automating the collection, right? So we can automate the collection using collection runner, and we can also monitor our collection, which means that, you know, you can schedule when you want to run your collection. All right, so we are going to see this in this video. So let's move to our Postman. And in previous video, we have worked on all these requests this far. So all I have done is, in the interest of time, I've just made a copy of that and gave it a name, Animal Collection Runner. And inside that, you see the first copies folder. And inside that, you have five requests in a specific order, because when we do the testing, we follow the CRUD operations, right? We create, we read, we update, and then we delete. So create is our post, read is our get, update is put and patch, and then eventually we are deleting the resource. Okay. And in the second copy, again, the requests are same. And then we have request at the collection level. I wanted to show the order in which these requests are executed. So first the folder level requests are executed, and then the request at the root of the collections are executed. That's a default order. You can change it, and we'll see that how to do that. And I also made a couple of changes in here. If you could see that, because I'm kind of changing these requests, and we'll talk again about request chaining in detail in upcoming videos. But I just wanted to set up this relationship, the chaining between these requests. So because we have to do the CRUD operations in here, so all I'm doing is whatever response that I'm getting after posting the request, I'm reading the ID of it so that I can use that into my subsequent request, right? That is it. This is all I've done. And because when we run the collection, we'll see the results as well. So for that, what I've done is I've added test cases at the collection level. Like I mentioned in the previous one of the previous video, that whatever things that are common to all the requests, you can lift those up to the collection level. All right, so here what I'm doing is based upon the request type, right, based on the method. What I'm doing is, if it's a delete, I'm expecting the status code to be 204. If it is a post, it is going to be 201, and otherwise pop put and get, it is going to be 200. And then I'm also checking the response time should be less than 700. So these are the few changes that I've done. Now it's time to move on to the topic, which is collection runner. So do one thing, let me minimize everything. So you have two ways actually to do that, and I like the second way. I'll start with the first one. So you can click on this, and that will show you all the collections that you have in this current workspace. Okay, and you can switch your workspace from here. All right, so now what you have to do is, you will see all the collections in here. You have to select this. All right, and then you'll see this window. The other way is, which is going to be much quicker than this, so all you have to do is hover over this, right, click on this play button, and this window will open. And from here you can see few more options, like, you know, you can set the monitoring. Currently I'm not set any monitoring, mocks, and any change logs. So if you have made any changes to this particular collection, all right, you also see the share button, and we are going to check that when we move toward, you know, working on Newman. So you can generate the public link of your collection. So through this, and then you're going to use this link in Newman, but topic for some other video. In this video, all you have to do is click on this run button, which is going to open the same window which you just saw, like, you know, 10 seconds back. Yeah, so you see that. Okay, so this is the default order. How you can change the execution order, you can change it like this. You can drag it, and then you could see get is at the top, but we want to do the CRUD operation, so post has to be at the top. So this way you can do the drag and drop and change the order. Now, because it is dependent upon an environment, you saw that I'm, from the response, I'm fetching the ID and storing that into the environment variable so that I can change that up in the subsequent request. So therefore I've selected the environment as QA, and iteration, let's make it 2. And delay is, let's see, let's add, okay, let's add 1 second of delay between each request. And in interest of time, again I created a JSON file for this video. Let's click on that, and this is there inside that. Okay, and let me just click on the run button. Now you see every request is getting generated after 1 second. So there's a delay of 1 second. So I'll show you without delay as well. Okay, so there are 30 tests, and what you can do is, so this, click on green, and you will see all the test cases that are passed. In our case, all the test cases are passed, no fail. So this will be empty in our case. And this will be because there is only one iteration. So you see only one iteration in here. Okay, let's do one thing. Let's go back to our collection and remove this part to save some time and make it 2. Okay, and run the collection again. So now this time it's much faster, and there would be 2 executions. Okay, So again, all 60 test cases are passed. Earlier it was 30. Now it's 60. So you can filter out the iteration by clicking on this and check the results of each iteration. Okay. So you can also check the summary. And here also you have iteration 1 and iteration 2. Okay. Let's go back and let's change one of the test cases to see if some of the test cases are failing or not. So I'm gonna close this and go to my collection and change the time to, let's say, 200 milliseconds. And that's the advantage. See, because I have lifted these common test cases up to the collection level, I just have to make change at one place. Imagine you have declared this test case at all the requests, which means at 15 different places. So you needed to change it at 15 different places. So just click on the update. All right, and let's run this again and see if any test cases are failing this time. So environment is selected, iteration is 2, select file. Check the preview, it's loaded properly. Run the collection. I hope I have selected 2 iterations. No, just 1 iteration. Okay, let's select 2 iterations. Yeah, at least some test cases are failing. No case, good. So it's executed. So this time 10 test cases are failed. So click on iteration 1. This will show you all the past test cases. This will show you all the failed test cases. And you could see that the response time was 378. We were expecting it to be below 200. Okay. Yeah. And you could see that there are 5 requests in the first folder. And they are differentiated by this FC 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Then you have 5 SC, and then you have 5 normal requests, right? And then your second iteration starts. Okay. Now one thing is export results. So you can click on export results, and it is going to export the result in the form of a JSON. Okay. So you can export that, and so we monitor, we already talked about change log. Okay, we have already talked about, and is there anything pending? Let's see. No, I guess. Yeah, so I wanted to show you this as well. So you can see that here you will see the result of all your recent runs. Okay, so last one was failed, and prior to that these were passing. So you can click on that, it will take you to the result summary again. Okay, so this is about collection runner. Thank you, thanks for watching. Bye-bye.